Now here's a common situation you may have with your Apple ID account, also known as your iCloud account or iTunes account. It's your one Apple account. And your ID for that is going to be an email address. Now that email address could be something at iCloud.com or, if it's older, at me.com or at mac.com. In that case, you're using an Apple email address for an Apple account. But it could also be something at a completely different email address, like a Gmail account or something with your ISP. It could be anything. Any email address could be used as an Apple ID. And if you set up your Apple ID a long time ago, it may very well be some email address that has nothing to do with Apple. Now what happens is people change email addresses. They leave an ISP or they decide to stop using an email account and maybe start using their iCloud email account or a new one. But they're stuck with an Apple ID that's using their old email address. So how do you change it? Well, the key to changing it first is going to this page at Apple's website, and it explains in detail everything you need to do. And you should first read this page carefully because there are a lot of different starting points. For instance, if you already have an Apple ID that's at iCloud.com or at me.com or at mac.com and you want to change it, there's certain things that you need to do. I'm going to focus here on if your Apple ID is using a third-party email address. So say it's using your ISP's email address and you're not using that anymore. You can still change that so you can basically not have to worry about that old email address. Maybe you don't even use it for other things anymore. You can change it to another email address that you have or even to an iCloud.com email address. And the steps are here. So basically what you want to do for most occasions is sign out of just about everything. Now, if you're trying to do this on an iOS device, you don't want to sign out on the one iOS device you're actually going to use. But let's assume you're going to do this on a Mac. So you're going to sign out of everything because you're going to go to Safari and you're going to sign in there. So you can have your Mac signed out, you can have all of your devices signed out and everything. That way there'll be no problems as you change your Apple ID. So as it instructs us here, we want to go to appleid.apple.com and sign in and go to the account section and click edit and look for a change Apple ID button. So here I am at appleid.apple.com. I'm going to sign in using my demo account here. So great. So now I'm at this demo account. Now hopefully you're not still using security questions. You're using two-factor authentication. I'm only using security questions here because this is a demo account that I used to demonstrate things. And here you can see is where you've got the ability to do lots of changes like changing your password, changing your security questions, that kind of thing. So what we want to find is the ability to change your account. So we're going to click edit here. And now we can see we have change Apple ID. I'll click on that. And this is where I can start the process entering a new email address to use as my Apple ID. Now it's going to go through several more steps and verify. If we go back here to the page, it will say that if you enter a new Apple ID that uses iCloud.com, me.com, or mac.com, you'll get a message to confirm. And you're going to have had that already added to that account. It explains that all here. But if it's a third-party email account, then you'll get the opportunity to verify. And so you'll get an email there verifying that you want to use this account and everything like that. That way you can't accidentally mistype the email address and now you've changed it to something you don't have access to. So this is how you do it. And afterwards you sign back in using your new Apple ID. Thank you.